Bursledon Brickworks was founded in 1897 by the Ashby family. The Ashbys were partners in Hooper and Ashby's successful builders' merchants in Southampton. They also made bricks. The site closed in 1974 for several reasons. The M27 split the site in two. The clay was getting very expensive to extract. The factory slowly ran down. First to go were the clay diggers, and the last the kiln burners. A new chapter for the history of the factory started. In 2020, the museum was awarded a Heritage Lottery Fund grant of £666,300. This grant was awarded to help and create the museum. This is the Lancashire boiler, which provided the steam for much of the Bursledon Brickworks. The old boiler survived, but only just. It was more solidly built, using boilerplate metal for its outer cladding, rather than the sheet metal used on the later oil-fired one before being upgraded in 1997. All the machinery at the brickworks was run by steam, and most of it still does. This single cylinder engine of 1885 by John Wood of Wigan has a 16 by 30 inch slide valve cylinder, a Pickering governor, 4-bar crosshead guides and a disc crank. A recent event held at the museum saw model railways running both inside and outside. Also on display are two magnificent traction engines. This one, a Garrett and named the Netley Bell, was built in 1917. She was a showman's tractor and still has this splendid paintwork. The brass pipework, levers and wheels bring the steam giant into action once the right steam pressure is reached. The second engine is a Fowler's Road Roller and built in 1931. Somewhat later than the Netley Bell sitting next to her. Outside you will walk past the hall's patent brick making machine. You can see the blacksmiths at work, and it's fascinating to watch them make something out of a plain piece of metal. A very skilled trade that you don't often see these days. There's something special about seeing a steam engine working. The smells and the sounds are nothing to compare in this modern world. I was able to chat to one of the volunteers and asked him about the history of this engine.
Sat around in the yard for about 10 years before we decided to site it here. It takes a lot of looking after, you know what I mean? Although it's heavy machinery, it's well engineered for its time. Everything on it is well over engineered. This site is the original site for the boiler room, and foundations of the old boiler room are still underneath this lot. We had the archaeological people who were saying, no, you can't take them up because they're red tiles and they're 2 inches thick and they're a foot square.
The museum today tells the story of brickmaking in Britain, from the clay pits to the kilns. Housed in original Victorian Grade II listed buildings is the original brickmaking machinery. Here we see a typical office layout of the time. Sport was important to the workforce and was played. This included football teams, also a tug of war, and the trophies were somewhat different from the normal, as the sign explains. Everyday objects we see here include wooden cupboards for storage, tea mugs, and I suspect a well-used game of dominoes. The drying sheds at Bursledon Brickworks were patented by the owners, mostly because of the use of the wooden floor slats. These protected the bottom layer of bricks from the underfloor heating. If the bricks got too hot, they would twist and crack and be useless. It's back to the Model Railway Room, and the Victory Model Railway Club are here exhibiting their new and current railway project. The club chairman was able to tell me the plans for this new layout.
Well, it's a modern day era layout, and we were experimenting with using DCC. The club voted to start a new layout, and we've spent 4 years learning all about digital so that we can incorporate it into this layout. Along the front section is our main scenic section. We've got plans in place to make a motorway flyover at the entrance of the layout. Then further down there'll be overhead catenary with a substation, a brickworks which incorporates Victory Pass because it was Victory Brickworks. And then further down the line there will be a tunnel finishing the scenic section with an overhead village.
Back inside the museum are plenty of large, and I mean large, engines. Just off the passage, we find a hard brick press. Mr. Batley was a manager at the brickworks and designed and patented this press. Ever heard of rubbing bricks? The skill first came to this country from the Flemish brickmakers. Rubbed bricks can be carved, shaped and layered with a very much smaller mortar joint, and all kinds of decorative effects can be created. There is a huge collection of tiles and ceramic building materials, including land drains and chimney pots. Many of these are on display in the collection housed upstairs, in one of the former drying rooms. As you may know, bricks are made of clay, and this is only partially true. Clay makes the mix easy to form into the right shape, but if used on its own, creates poor bricks. The museum maintains a comprehensive archive of published material, both historic and contemporary. Here is a tool chest made and used by Thomas Holloway Jr., 1860 to 1928. In the chest, you can see the assortment of tools he would have used every day of his working life. As well as bricks on display, you will also see the many assortments of roof tiles. Regulations encouraged the use of tiles to stop the spread of fires. It gradually happened over time, and by the 19th century, fire clay tiles became the most popular roofing material. Clay tiles are made from the same basic materials as bricks, although the mix is a little different. Their thickness makes them vulnerable to breaking throughout the manufacturing process. When the brickworks were in operation in the early 1900s, narrow gauge railways were used to move the clay around the site, which has long since gone. However, you will find a 7.25-inch miniature gauge railway, which will take you on a ride from the station around a circuit. As like the narrow gauge railway, horses were also used at the brickworks. Back outside and under a marquee is the 16mm Association running trains today, a little bigger than the 00 gauge we saw earlier. Real steam powered along, with the odd Dalek whizzing by throughout the day. A few military vehicles are also here on display, as well as this unusual three-wheeled car. I've enjoyed taking a look around the museum, and worth another visit, I'm sure. So until the next time, cheerio.